Franchises are a huge part of AAA gaming nowadays, and it seems that every time a big budget game comes out, it is tied to an existing franchise in one way or another, be it because it's a main entry or it's a spinoff. But just because a game is part of an established franchise does not mean that it has to be similar to it. What's up, everybody? Welcome to Chaos Top 10s, and today we are going to be checking out 10 games that changed everything. They changed the formula for this list. We will be looking at games that were entries in established franchises, but they featured gameplay that was nothing like the previous game, but still managed to be well received in the gaming industry. Be sure to let me know which of these games as we go through this list are some of your favorites. Take a second, hit that like button, and let's get started. Kicking off our list is BioShock Infinite. Critically acclaimed is one way to put it. This first-person shooter changed everything. Released in March of 2013, Infinite was the third game in the BioShock series and was a pretty dramatic departure from the already established formula. Up until this point, BioShock was more of a horror series featuring creepy environments, terrifying enemies, and very, very dark subject matter. Infinite, on the other hand, was a much more straightforward action game with a very bright color palette and a story that was much more human and much less monster-focused. Now, Infinite is also much more action-packed than the previous games, which some people criticize while others actually loved. Overall, BioShock Infinite was praised by critics for its excellent story and characters, and it changed the game. At number 9, Guitar Hero World Tour. Does anybody remember Guitar Hero? It used to be one of the biggest franchises in the gaming world, and tons of people still have fond memories with the series. However, when Rock Band came on the scene and introduced the concept of having four-player co-op in a rhythm game with everybody using different instruments, Activision wanted in on the party, so they reworked the Guitar Hero formula from the ground up for the fourth mainline entry, World Tour, which came out in 2008. Now, not only did World Tour introduce drums and vocals to the Guitar Hero formula, but it also introduced various gameplay mechanics like the slider bar, the custom characters, tap notes, and even a custom music creator for anyone to make their own music. They could chart it, they could allow anyone in the world to download their music. World Tour was a huge success, and it was the seventh highest grossing video game ever for a while. I'm running a huge Fortnite 15,000 V-Bucks giveaway the entire month. All you have to do to enter is like this video, be subscribed to the channel, turn on your notifications, and leave me a comment why you want to win with your Twitter handle attached. The winner will be picked at the end of the month. At number 8, we have Metroid Prime. Now, Metroid is a long-running action-adventure game where you played as a fearsome bounty hunter, Samus Aran, as she went around the galaxy and did battle with various space pirates and, of course, her arch-nemesis, Ridley. The first game was released all the way back on the NES, and then it got two sequels, Metroid 2 on the Game Boy and Super Metroid on the Super NES. But after Super Metroid came out in 1994, there was an 8-year hiatus before we finally got Metroid Prime on the GameCube, and you'd be forgiven for thinking that it wasn't even part of the same franchise. Up until this point, Metroid was a 2D platformer, but Metroid Prime shifted that series into first-person perspective with wide-open worlds, tons of gadgets for combat, and huge boss fights. Now, the general Metroid formula remained intact in Metroid Prime. The gameplay and the method of control, though, was completely changed, and it was definitely a good change since Metroid Prime is often regarded as one of the greatest games ever made. At number 7, we have Grand Theft Auto 3. Now, GTA started off as a cheesy top-down action game for the PC, PS1, and the Game Boy, but when the gaming world really started taking off and home console markets started pushing the boundaries for technology, Rockstar decided it was time to shake things up. Grand Theft Auto 3 was released for the PS2 in 2001, and it completely changed the franchise as well as gaming as a whole. It shifted the series from a top-down perspective to a third-person open-world action-adventure game with a living, breathing map for you to interact with. You could steal cars, get in shootouts with the police, and there was a long single-player campaign with a great story in it. GTA 3 created the GTA formula as we know it today. It was a massive influence on open-world gaming as a whole, and you're about to get Red Dead Redemption 2. It wouldn't have happened if they hadn't made GTA 3. At number 6, we have God of War, the reboot. I'm sure all of you know this game pretty well by now. God of War is a long-running hack-and-slash franchise for the PS2 and 3, but in 2018, Sony took a risk. They took a chance. They decided to completely rework the formula for the modern gaming industry, and they gave us a rebooted, amazing game, God of War, kind of more like a Dark Souls game, and it had a much more story-driven campaign with an open-world map and a much, slower third-person combat than the normal over-the-top hack-and-slash combat that the series was known for. Now, many fans for the series were a little disappointed with the core gameplay kind of being dramatically changed. There's no denying the overall quality, though, of the game, and right now, it's looking like a hot contender for Game of the Year. Cracking into the top five today, we have Star Wars Republic Commando. And I know, Star Wars isn't exactly a gaming franchise since there's so many Star Wars games spanning countless different genres, but I am putting Republic Commando as a tactical first-person shooter with squad mechanics and pretty graphic violence, and it was released for the Xbox and the PC, and it's going to make this list. You play it as an elite group of clone troopers during the beginning of the Clone Wars in between episodes 2 and 3, and the writing was nothing short of excellent. Republic Commando was critically acclaimed for its deep gameplay, its great story, and its replayability factor, although fans are still pretty pissed about the cliffhanger ending since the sequel was canceled and we never got any closure. At number 4, Doom 3. Now, Doom is known for being fast-paced. It's over the top. Everybody knows this, as well as being one of the most influential franchises of all time. The original Doom was released in 93. Then, we got a good reboot in 2016. But in between then and now, there was a mainline Doom game that many fans of the series tend to forget about because it was so different. Doom 3 was released for the Xbox and the PC in 2004, and it was actually a survival horror game with an emphasis on dark environments and shadow mechanics, where you had to use your flashlight to get yourself through literally pitch black environments filled with demons from hell. Now, Doom 3 was disliked by fans of the series due to it being nothing like the other Doom games, which is totally understandable, but if you approach Doom 3 as a survival horror game and not as a Doom extension, it's actually a pretty good game, and it holds up surprisingly well thanks to the excellent lighting and the graphic design. At number 3, Fallout 3. Now, Fallout is one of the biggest franchises in gaming and one of Bethesda's most prized possessions. However, a lot of people forget that before Bethesda took over the post-apocalyptic RPG, it actually looked and played entirely different. The first Fallout was released in 97 for the PC and the Mac, and it was actually a turn-based RPG with a top-down third-person perspective. Fallout 2 then came out in 98 for PC, and it featured similar gameplay, but after Fallout 2, there would not be a mainline Fallout game for 10 years, and during that time, Bethesda acquired the series and decided to put their own spin on it. So in 2008, Fallout 3 was released, sporting a graphical makeover, a first-person perspective, and a real-time combat as opposed to turn-based. Fallout 3 laid the foundation for what would become one of the biggest RPG franchises ever. Speaking of big franchises, at number 2, we're going to go with Resident Evil 7. Now, RE has had a ton of missteps over the years, but thankfully, RE7 was able to set things right again, at least for a little bit. RE7 was released in 2017, and it featured a first-person perspective and much, much smaller scope of a story, making it kind of feel more intimate and making the enemies feel much more intimidating than they did in the over-the-top sequences from RE5 and RE6. Now, 7 was a huge success and one of the best horror games in years, although, I'm still skeptical on whether or not this means that Capcom has their stuff together for the future of the series, because they like to put out a masterpiece and then they like to follow that up with a complete turd. So we'll have to wait and see for Resident Evil 8. And finally, speaking of Resident Evil, we are going to put in the number one spot today, Resident Evil 4. And like I said, Capcom, they make masterpieces from time to time, and this is one of the best horror games ever made, and perhaps the most influential third-person shooter of all time. Some people would argue Gears of War. Now, RE4 was released in early 2005, and it moved the series from a locked camera gameplay to free-roaming, over-the-shoulder, third-person perspective, and it also featured a much better story than previously. Now, RE4's story was a little more campy vibe, but it fit well with the characters and the setting, and it's also the first game in the series to make use of quick time events, which unfortunately overstayed their welcome in later installments. But RE4 is still the best game in the series, and without a doubt, one of the best horror games ever made. And if you haven't played this game, I highly, highly recommend trying it out this Halloween season. And there you go, my friends. Those are 10 video games that changed everything, and they changed their own formula, which can be risky at times. You guys, let me know which game on this list do you think did it the best? Hopefully you guys enjoyed. If you did, take a second, subscribe, turn on those notifications, ring that little bell, check that box so you never miss an upload. And I'm going to get back to doing a gaming top 10 every single night. I'll see you guys soon.